Shalom, you're watching Arutz Sheva TV. I'm Yoni Kipinski, and this is our daily edition. The Protective Edge counter-terror operation is still at large. Many successes, but also grave price. More than 30 IDF soldiers have been killed since the beginning of the ground attack.
We come from a very small family, but that seemed to quickly change after meeting people in Israel who instantly felt like one big family.
We initially said that we wanted to bring our son back home to Los Angeles. After further thought, we came to realize that was our selfishness. I just wanted him near me and wanted to be able to go see him every day if I needed to. But after being in Israel and seeing all the love and support and how he is treated and remembered here, we decided that Max needed to remain in Israel, no longer the lone soldier, forever at his home. We concluded that the Israeli people would honor him for his sacrifice and provide him with the lasting respect he deserves.
And pray for peace to our beloved son. May your memory burn everlasting in the hearts of your friends here in Israel, as it will amongst all your family and friends in the United States of America.
One of the significant attacks we were informed of is the attack on what used to be a hospital. IDF reported that Hamas has turned the Wafa hospital into a command center and rocket launching site. Hamas has fired at Israel and at the IDF forces from the hospital, and so as a result, the IDF repeatedly conveyed warnings to the hospital staff and urged civilians to leave the area. Hamas continued firing from the hospital. In response, the IDF targeted specific sites and terrorists within the hospital grounds. In the video footage of the attack, secondary explosions can be seen, confirming IDF intelligence about this site.
طب مستشفى الوفا احنا نحكي عن السجاير عشان يكون متاكدين انه فيش غاد مرضى فيش اشي يعني بس ما في مرضى غاد كيف الحال؟
حكيت الحمد لله حكيت انا كمان مره بحكي
لك مدير المستشفى رد عليك مدير المستشفى؟
حكيت معاه حكى لي انه بالنسبه له ما في اي طواقم طبيه موجوده ولا مرضى هو سكر المستشفى سكر كل ابواب المستشفى وما فيش مجال لاي حدا يدخل من المستشفى لانها مغلقه
بس انت حكيت يعني مع السيد قال لك فيش حدا منهم غاد لانه احنا بهمنا نوضح كمان يعني اذا بيكون في يعني عنا لقواتنا من غاد استهداف وبكون في نشطاء اللي هن يعني لسه موجودين بقلب المستشفى وبيسووا لنا استهداف يعني بتعرف انت حسب يعني عنا يعني كمان قانون الدول اللي هو بيسمح لنا كمان احنا انه احنا بدنا نحافظ يعني 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 احنا غاد نحافظ على جنودنا وبدنا نحافظ كمان على يعني بتعرف المواطنين مواطنين دوله اسرائيل ما يكونش اطلاق نار من غاد ما يكونش كمان من غاد اطلاق صواريخ
One of the main objectives of the operation, as stated by many, many officials, is of course the destruction of the terror tunnels. In this footage released by the army, soldiers from the Givati Infantry Brigade are uncovering and entering a concealed terror tunnel in Gaza, discovering weapons and explosives. Since July 8th, IDF forces in Gaza have uncovered 30 tunnels with nearly 70 access points, which were to be used to infiltrate Israel and carry out attacks against civilians. In addition to the infantry forces, also the heavy vehicles are coming in and participating in the ground attack. As can be seen here, the IDF tank corps entered the Gaza Strip. Here's a taste of what went on there on the internal radio broadcast between the commander and his soldiers.
תסרקו היטב, תשמידו מה שצריך להשמיד, תחפשו את הפירים, תחפשו את האויב ותעשו את זה הכי טוב שאתם יכולים. שאלו כולם בהצלחה, בואו.
Colonel Rassan Aliyan, the commander of the Golani Brigade, was wounded while fighting Hamas in the Gaza Strip. This week he already returned to his troops after recovering in the hospital.
חזרתי לחטיבה וללוחמים אחרי שטיפלו בבית חולים. אני חוזר להמשיך את המשימה של החטיבה, להצטרף ללוחמים שעדיין עושים את העבודה. אנחנו מאוד חזקים, אנחנו יציבים, אנחנו נעשה את הכל בשביל להשלים את המשימה עד הסוף. אני מתעדכנתי במהלך היום וחצי האחרונים שהחבר'ה המשיכו, פגעו בלא מעט מחבלים, השיגו חלק גדול מהמשימה. יש לנו עוד טיפה ואנחנו נסיים את זה. אני גם רוצה לנצל את ההזדמנות להעביר למשפחות השכולות שחטיבת גולני היא חטיבה חזקה, חטיבה שמחבקת אותם, חטיבה שתחבק אותם גם בעתיד, ולפצועים שראיתי חלקם בבית חולים, החלמה מהירה, עם עריות. אני מצטרף ללוחמים בשטח שעושים את העבודה הרצינית, ואני אפגוש אותם כבר בערב.
Despite the ongoing terror attacks, the IDF makes sure to continue allowing the supply of food and other essential supplies into the Gaza Strip. The IDF spokesperson unit produced the following video regarding this.
Workers at Israeli security crossings face constant danger as a result of rockets fired by terrorist organizations in Gaza. Despite these risks, the crossings allow trucks carrying supplies to enter the Gaza Strip. The IDF goes beyond its legal obligations when facilitating these aid transfers. Medical equipment, food, gas, hygiene products, and other supplies necessary for the civilian population are transported into Gaza through the Kerem Shalom crossing. The IDF works closely with international organizations in order to determine which goods need to be transferred, when, and in what amount. The Liaison and Coordination Administration makes every effort to continue its activities for as long as the security situation permits, even amid ongoing terror attacks.
The FAA, the Federal Aviation Administration, renewed the ban regarding the flights to Israel for another 24 hours Wednesday, citing the potentially hazardous situation in Israel and Gaza. The decision means that U.S. airlines will avoid Israeli skies for a second day, pending a decision in Washington on whether to lift the ban on all U.S. flights due to the escalation in Gaza. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu welcomed former mayor of New York Michael Bloomberg at Ben-Gurion Airport. Bloomberg flew in to express his objection to the FAA decision.
Michael, I want to welcome you to Israel. You're always welcome on any day, but especially on this day. You come here as a true leader, as a true friend, and as a man who stands for the truth. And the truth is, what you wanted to demonstrate by coming here, is that this airport is open, that you can fly in and out of Israel. We protect this airport. There's no reason whatsoever for the mistaken FAA decision to instruct American planes not to come here. I think you're proving it by coming here. Where I stand, the Prime Minister of Israel, where you stand, anybody can stand. I think this decision only rewards the Hamas terrorists for nothing. You can fly in and out of Israel, and I hope that the FAA rescinds this decision as soon as possible.
If I would argue that Ben-Gurion Airport is probably the safest airport in the whole world to fly in and out of. This is a country that's been threatened since its existence back in 1948, when the United Nations created this country as a homeland for the Jews. And the Israelis know what it is to keep people safe.
Thank you, Michael. Thank you very much.
Earlier today, we spoke with the spokesperson of the Israel Aviation Authority.
Ben-Gurion Airport is the most safe airport in the world. It's the most safe place in Israel, and there is no reason that people are not going to come to fly to Israel.
The Strong Together movement, which consists of around 20 organizations from throughout the political spectrum in Israel, sent out to the streets this week to show support for the IDF and the State of Israel. The rallies took place simultaneously in around 100 locations throughout the country.
My name is Tatiana Hassan. I'm from Boston. I'm here for the summer. I'm volunteering for 2 months. And I got here before this whole conflict was going on, before anything, there was really any violence or anything really hard. And then sort of as I've been here, everything's been escalating. But even though it's hard to be here, I couldn't be happier to be at this time, to be part of the Jewish people and to be part of this fight and support for our soldiers, and I couldn't have chose a better place to be tonight than to support our people. I think it depends on the community, but I really think that based on what I've seen from my family and friends back home, there's a lot of support from America, and I think it's important that they continue to support America and to support Israel from America, because there is a lot of anti-Israel sentiment also. But as long as we stay strong from there, we got to keep fighting.
Since the beginning of the counter-terror operation, activists have been working around the clock at the Communication Center of the Center for Diaspora Communications and Countering Anti-Semitism in the World Zionist Organization, the WZO. The center serves as a hub for a global network of Zionist activists committed to standing up to anti-Semitism. The multilingual team of interns uses social networking to monitor, track, and expose anti-Semitic statements and expressions. Our correspondent Chesky Ezra visited the center during the day of activity.
Good morning, everyone. We're starting our day with some news about what has been going on in the diaspora due to the operation Defensive Edge. We have the latest shootings from France. The entire community has been suffering from riots by anti-Semitic Muslims mostly.
Since the beginning of the operation in Gaza, we've been witnessing a tremendous rise on anti-Semitic expressions, both in the Jewish communities around the world, against the Jews around the world, and specifically over the internet. We have volunteers from the Jewish people around the world that are coming here on a daily basis in order to give a straight answer, a definite answer that anti-Semitism is out of this equation.
I'm here spending a summer working at the WZO, helping to counter anti-Semitism online, and we report a lot of what's going on. We send out newsletters to the diaspora, we monitor the Facebook pages, and it's really, we're doing good work here.
We use the, we research different websites to try to make sure we get the most reliable information to find out where these issues are happening, where these riots are happening, where these protests, anti-Israel, anti-Jewish, and we use this information to let people know what's going on and what they can do about it.
My name is Isaac Levy, and I'm a student from Boston University. And I'm currently working for a few months in Israel to combat anti-Semitism and to work on some Israel advocacy. It's especially important to me as an American Jew to do my little part to help in the fight against anti-Semitism and to do something very important work for the sake of my nation.
Okay, that'll be all for today's Daily Edition. We'll be back tomorrow with more. But of course, you can get all our news updated and in depth on Arutz 7, IsraelNationalNews.com.